it's a special day today. We are honoring three persons. The first person is Mike Harris, a paratrooper from Easy Company 2nd Battalion 501st, who passed away in February. And it's his jacket with great honor. We received that jacket here. That's the ceremony handover.
Hello and good morning, everybody. My name is André Maris. I was born within the Bastogne area and was, as a kid of only 7 of age, wounded during the siege of this latter town by the German forces in December 1944. Some of the American ground forces took care of my wounds and finally saved my right arm from complete amputation. It chiefly explains why the major part of my best friends is all made of World War II veterans born and living in the United States of America.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
My heart.
Good morning. I have just one. It's an honor to welcome you all in the 101st Airborne Museum, and most especially the veterans. We live in peace in Europe for almost 70 years. That's a long time. A lot of people feel that this is normal and don't consider that this isn't. This freedom cost a lot of sacrifice. Allied soldiers who find their last place in the soil of Europe. To deal with this future, it is important that we know our history. Don't forget what happened and share this history with the next generation. We hope that we can contribute to this cause with this museum. We are open now for almost a year and the reactions are overwhelming. We work together with the barracks and the museum in Diekirch to conserve our history. Our visitors are from all over the world and from all ages. Despite that we just have opened our doors for keeping doors, we're keeping developing. Next year this museum will extend it with an opening of the basement, which will be an experience with fighting scenes, a hospital and a bombing cave. We also extend the tubes, so they will contribute even more to education. We will add more information about the whole museum and we will start a special program for schools. To share history facts are important, that therefore are the personal stories of the veterans. That's a big value. We are very happy that we can tell the story of Mike Harris. Thank you very much.
So that's a certificate of appreciation that I would like you to bring to Anne Harris for our support.
I would be privileged to do that.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. I'll be glad to take that to Anne and to Rob.
Yeah, really give all of this.
Okay, welcome, Vince, Howard. Thank you for joining us in this special occasion for the presentation of Mike Harris's uniform. For many years now, our airborne unit has been escorting the World War II veterans back to Belgium for the special occasion of the Nuts weekend ceremonies and the commemorations of the liberation of the Belgian people. Many friends here in Belgium have opened up their hearts and their homes to my wife Linda and I, and to especially our World War II heroes that have returned. I'm forever grateful for all of the Belgian people, and we're going to continue this mission of bringing the veterans back until the last World War II veteran is no longer able physically to travel across the pond from the United States. It's my privilege today to be with you during this special ceremony. We're honoring the late Redrick Mike Harris, Easy Company 501st Parachute Infantry Regiment, 101st Airborne Division. At the request of Mike's widow, Ann, and his son, Ron, and Henri Maurice, today we formally present this 101st Airborne uniform to the 101 Airborne Museum here in Bastogne. This jacket of Mike's will be displayed in this beautiful museum. Please know that when it is on display, it's at the complete fulfillment of the request of Ann and of Ron. And may this uniform be a lasting reminder of the courage and the sacrifice that Mike made, along with many, many thousands of other veterans of the Allied forces, to help liberate the people of Belgium in World War II. Commander Bowman, would you come forward? This morning I officially present from the family of Redrick Mike Harris his World War II uniform jacket to the 101 Airborne Museum here in Bastogne. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning, Howard Hale with the 14th Cavalry Division that fought in Vilsalm, St. Vith, the northern area here. This is Howard's first time back to Belgium since 1944-45. And Howard, we have a special presentation from the U.S. Department of Army for you this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? And on the military protocol, attention to orders. To all that are present today, greetings. This is to honor exemplary service during the Battle of the Bulge, which defeated the last major Nazi offensive in World War II. Your service is recognized by the presentation of this World War II Battle of the Bulge Medal. This medal is presented to Howard Lewis Hale for exemplary service while serving in the United States Armed Forces. This performance of duty represents patriotism in the finest tradition of the Armed Forces of the United States of America and reflects great credit upon the recipient, yourself, and your service. Commander, would you have the privilege of pinning the medal? I present to you, my friend, the certificate